Riffical Records presents the Projekt Gemineye Update with your host, Mark Anthony Kay. Greetings, friends, and welcome to Projekt Gemineye Update number 74. So we all know why we're here today. Today we're going to be doing the draw for the test pressing. Today being February 23rd. The time being officially 1:15 in the afternoon, and we'll be drawing a name today, and the lucky winner will receive his very own test pressing of Man of Science, Man of Dreams. I will of course sign it for you as well, and it'll be sent to you as soon as possible. There were 21 names in the contest. Thank you very much. That was great. They have been all entered into my lucky kiss hat. I'm sure people who have been involved in my contest before recognize this hat. They have been all put in into these little forms of paper, and you will be drawn out. And the way we're going to do this is my preferred way of doing it, in the way I think a lot of other people prefer having contests done. And that is by, hang on, I'm going to turn this light off, it's really bothering me. Is we're going to draw, and the last person out of the hat will be the winner. I've always hated this way of doing it, where people would draw the first name and then that's it. It's like so melodramatic, it's over before you even know it. So, 21 names were entered. There are no multiple names. Everybody just gets one entry. So without any further ado, let us draw the names out of the magical kiss hat. I'm going to move the microphone over. Sorry, I hope that isn't scratching in someone's ear if they're listening on headphones. Okay, so magical hat. Mix it up. And let's start drawing. The first name out of the hat is James Griffin. James Griffin is a fantastic artist out of Ireland with his band Zombie Picnic. He's a great guy. Thanks for entering, James. Better luck next time. Next name is, let's try this one. Next one out of the hat is Esther Kessel. Esther is a journalist. She reviews lots of progressive rock albums and stuff. Fantastic writer. Big, important person in the progressive scene. So, thank you very much for entering, Esther, and better luck next time. Next one. Next one out of the hat is Peter Kleige. I'm not sure if I know how to pronounce your last name. Peter Kleige. From Germany, I believe he's from. A very big supporter of the progressive music scene. Posts lots of stuff on Facebook, on my page, and on many other people's. I'm a big supporter of Projekt Gemineye since the beginning, I think. So, thanks again, Peter, for entering. And better luck next time, my friend. Next one out of the hat is Havard Lund. He was the first one who entered the contest. Havard Lund was the one who came up next. He's in a band called Moonscape, who have an excellent album out. He is working on his next album now. If you haven't heard it yet, look up Moonscape online. I'm pretty sure he's on Spotify and other spots. You can hear some fantastic progressive music. Okay, next up is Tony Romero, the last man to enter the contest. Very energetic individual, is very much involved in the social scene. loves music from what I can tell, and a supporter of Project Gemini. So thank you for entering, my friend, and better luck next time. All right, we're going and going. What's next? Let's try this one. Steve Wright, good friend. He does the Potted in Hell podcast, a fantastic podcast, covers all kinds of music, rock, metal, progressive, you name it. They do all kinds of excellent different types of episodes, best guitarists, best bass players, covers all kinds of different bands and stuff. So he has a fantastic podcast. You should really check it out, Potted in Hell. And better luck next time, Steve. Next up we have... Joe Grubbs. This man is responsible, I believe, for Vinyl Discoveries page. I think he's one of the ones involved in it. He posts a lot on there. He has a huge collection of vinyl. All kinds of stuff from blues, jazz, metal, like everything. He has a fantastic assortment of albums on Vinyl Discoveries, so check him out. He's a huge supporter of Project Gemini, and I thank you very much for your support, Joe, and better luck next time. Next up, we have Alex Walker. As we all know, Alex is a fellow podcaster with me on the Kiss FAQ podcast, another very enthusiastic supporter of Project Gemini, and I appreciate his enthusiasm and his support of the band very much. I'm sorry, my friend. Better luck next time. Next up, we have this one. Let's try this one. Preston Michael Fraser. He's another music journalist, something else, music reviews, I believe it's called. Great guy, bass player, loves all kinds of music, mainly progressive. Does some great reviews. He's doing a very lengthy review on the Yes catalog, where he goes through every album and every song off of each record. I believe he's somewhere around... I'm trying to think. Maybe he's on Keys to Ascension, around there? Somewhere around there. But he's done a huge amount of reviews. So, Something Else Reviews, I believe it's called. Something Else. So check him out. Preston Michael Fraser, if you look him up, his page will come up. And better luck next time. I really wish this thing would stop making that stupid noise. Okay, next we have Anthony Asaro, another longtime supporter of Project Gemini. Not as active on the page as other people, but very, very supportive of the band. I think everything that I've ever done, he has involved himself in, whether it's contests or buying of CDs or albums or whatever it is. Thank you very much, Anthony, for your continued support, and better luck next time, my friend. Okay, let's see. It's getting a little bit smaller, the pile now. Okay, next up is... Colin Powell. Fellow musician, lots of instrumental music he makes. Anybody who knows about progressive music, Colin Powell's name should not be unfamiliar. Doug Woods and Colin Powell have released, I think, 40 albums, or approaching that many albums, in the last like 4 years. I think the guys release like 4 albums a year. It's unbelievable how much music these guys write and release in a year. So better luck next time, Colin. And thanks again for your support. Next up we have... Let's try this one. Ryan Bannon, known as BB, another podcaster from the Potter and Hell podcast. again, great podcast, great guys. They know their stuff, and just absolutely great podcast. I love listening to it all the time, and I've been on their show about 3 or 4 times now, and have enjoyed it every single time I've been on. So check out their podcasts. Hey, there's some Project Gemineye episodes on there too, if you're interested. So thanks, Ryan, for your support. Better luck next time, my friend. Let's see what's next. Let's try this one. One of the 2 women entries. Andrea Webb from Germany. Fantastic artist. You should see some of the artwork that she does. And great photographer, too. Big supporter of Project Gemineye. And I thank you very much for your support. And better luck next time, Andrea. Let's keep going here. I don't want to make this video too long. Okay, next up we have Jeff Strong, fellow Canadian, in fact lives in Mississauga, which is not very far from me. Big supporter of Project Gemineye, great guy, always gets involved in all the contests and everything, and tough luck. You were pretty close, and we're getting near the end, so it's a bit of a heartbreak. Sorry about that, Jeff, maybe better luck next time. Okay, let's see. What do we have next here? How about this one? Jason Pollan. Everybody knows him. He lives in Wales, and he's the man who's helped me with numerous things for Project Gemineye, mainly the sort of graphic artwork stuff. He's done some of my ads for me that you've seen. He's done some really great ones. Maybe I'll post up one here for you guys to see. He's done that one there, and just great artwork, and a huge supporter of the band, and a big Kiss fan just like me. So thanks, Jason, for your support, and better luck next time. Ouch, I got a cramp in my foot. Okay, so we're down to the last couple, I'm suspecting, since there's not too many in this hat anymore. Yeah, let's try this one. Bill Elm. I believe that's how you say his name. What can I say about Bill? A very, very big supporter of Project Gemineye. Big supporter of music. Big supporter of podcasts, including the FAQ that I'm involved with. And if I'm not mistaken, you actually won something from an FAQ podcast recently, I think. Correct me if I'm wrong about that. But yeah, I'm not going to say better luck next time, because I think if I'm correct, you won something from the FAQ. So your luck might be pretty good, actually. But unfortunately, not this time for this. So sorry, my friend. Thank you very much for your support, though, Bill. And better luck next time. Okay. Now to the last couple. What do we have? What do we have? I'm trying to get a hold of one here. What's going on? Where's one? Okay, I'll try this one. Oh. The other woman. Rebecca Ramdahl. Rebecca Ramdahl is my sister, actually. She lives in Barrie. She's a big supporter of my music. She is a brilliant nutritionist, sort of a healthy lifestyle type person. She has all kinds of interesting recipes and useful guides to better living. And I've been trying to follow some of them a little bit more, because God knows I need to get my life into a bit better shape. I mean, you know, being a musician, my lifestyle was far from exemplary, from all the drugs, alcohol, and so on and so forth from years past. But I've been on a better road now, and my sister has a bit to do with that. So thank you, Rebecca. Thank you for your support. Better luck next time, sis. All right. Down to the last couple. Who will it be? What about this one? Let me see. I'm just going to probably read this one. There's one, two, three left. Okay. So this is number four. Well, the last four. This is the last. We're down to the last four. Oh. Doug Johansson from Australia. Big supporter. And one of the supporters that always has my utmost respect and support from my end, because being from Australia, the fact that he's always ordered a vinyl whenever it's come out, I have to give him just props and a tip of the hat, because the shipping to Australia for a record is just unbelievable. And I'm so glad that he hasn't, you know, just given up on ordering stuff because of the charges that it goes, that he has to pay to get them. So, and like I said, I'm trying my best to find an alternate way or a cheaper way for you, my friend, but sorry you didn't win the test press. Better luck next time, my friend. Down to the last three, I believe. Yes. Okay, let's mix these three up. What do we have here? Ah, number we have here Jan Braca, who runs the Epics for All Time podcast. It's a progressive podcast that plays music. That's a radio show then, I guess. And it's nothing but epic songs. So anything over 10 minutes long, that's all he plays on his show. So I'm lucky, because on Man of Science, I have a 14-minute song, as you guys know, Secret Science. And I've appeared on the show, and that's probably the only way I will appear on the show, because that's the only song I have that's over 10 minutes long. So thank you, Jan, for your support. And better luck next time, my friend. So we're down to two people. I know who one of them is, but I can't remember who the other name is. So let's mix these two up. Let's see. To grab one. Okay, I'll grab this one here. Yeah. Dave Rose. Now, this is ironic, because the last person who won a test pressing was Dave Rose. You came this close, my friend, to getting another test pressing. So, Dave Rose has an immense collection of albums. Just go to look up Dave Rose on Facebook, and you'll see these fantastic photos of his collection in this huge wall, like a shelf on this wall. And he has these photos with him and these fantastic dogs that he has there. Just absolutely gorgeous dogs. And I love looking at his photographs, just mainly for the albums, and also because of the dogs. I'm a huge dog lover, and his dogs are just absolutely gorgeous. So I love looking at his pictures. Dave, you came this close to another test pressing. Thank you for entering. Thank you for your support. And better luck next time, my friend. So that leaves one name. I believe I know who it is. And if it is who I think it is, I think he'll be happy. Yes, it is who I think it is. Ken Keenan, the voice of reason from the Kiss FAQ podcast, fellow podcaster, big supporter of Project Gemineye, and I believe Ken Keenan is member number one of the Gemineye Club, supporters club. So he's been there from the very start. He's been involved in all kinds of contests, big music supporter, supports my music all the time, and big Kiss guy. And like we say on the podcast, he is the voice of reason. Anytime we go off on some big tangents about Kiss and our crazy ideas, he's there to kind of bring us back down to earth. He is the voice of reason. Ken Keenan, thank you very much for entering and supporting. And you are the winner, my friend. So you will be getting the test pressing sent to you. I'll get a hold of you just to make sure I have the proper mailing address. And we'll arrange when you'll get it. If you want to get it when you get your album, or if you want to get it sent ahead of time, we'll discuss it when I talk to you. Okay? So there you go, my friends. Thank you very much for everybody who supported the contest and are continuing to support Project Gemineye. There will be much more of these kind of contests in the future. Lots of things to give away. I'm working on a few other things too, so there might be a contest sooner than later. Who knows? Anyways, thank you very much for everything, and I will talk to you guys all very soon. Bye for now.